How's it going? Welcome to
Between
Two Italians.
Yeah, you can do that.
Between Two Italians with Marco and Erica.
It's a very hot afternoon. It's like 43 degrees inside our apartment. I love the fact that you chose to wear flowers today.
Yes, art inspired me.
Art inspired us. Our next guest is amazing. It's amazing. She's done such a great career.
She works in one of the sectors that I love so much. Yes. So much.
Have you ever been a painter in your life?
No, but I think in another life I would love to be.
You would have loved,
yeah. I would have loved to.
Have you ever taken any brush in your hand and started painting?
I did actually. We did it the first time.
Oh yes, yes. You see.
I did. We painted something which looked like. And explosions of sun and moon.
I'm sure
and
it was
stars.
Amazing. Did we try to sell it for money?
No, I think we haven't. So far, it's in our apartment. But
it is, yeah. One day, its value is going to be awesome, man.
We don't know.
So if you're already familiar with the show, welcome back. If you're not familiar, it's me and Erica, and we ask embarrassing questions to our guests.
And we spread happiness. So shall we welcome her?
Or shall we sing?
Shall we sing first? Do you have a song which is perfect for this guest?
It's not perfect, but it's gonna be Ed Sheeran. When I was 60 years old, I broke my leg.
I was running with my brother and his friends.
And that for kiss on a Friday night.
I don't reckon he did it right.
But I was younger then. Take me back to when we found. And let's welcome her!
Let's welcome Nadia Moludova from the Florence Classical Arts Academy.
Thank you so much. Really great singing, guys.
Awesome.
Good
awesome.
To see you.
I love your background with all the paintings and I love your hair as well.
She looks like she's in literally the part of a painting herself.
Yeah, actually her blonde matches the frames,
exactly,
the frames of the painting. Have you chosen?
Thank you.
Is that your natural color?
You know, I'm Russian.
Oh, okay, you're Russian, so all blonde?
Blonde.
Okay, I don't know. Because I'm Italian.
To be blonde. You are not normal, huh?
I color my hair, it's a secret, so let's not say
you
this
paint
to anyone.
Your hair. Yeah.
I don't will tell no one.
Exactly, nobody knows, okay? So let's keep it between us.
Nadia,
no worry.
You are the founder of the Florence Classical Arts Academy. Such an honor.
How did this happen? How did you become a founder?
I had a vision when I was in my 19. I had the vision about all birds goes in different direction, and I had that voice, which is telling me what somehow I will be sending these birds. Who will be through art do something special?
So you had the vision, and you had a few birds.
Yeah.
The few birds you
not
want
few,
to...
quite a lot.
Oh, quite a lot, like a thousand birds.
Yeah, but in my 19, I can't understand how it's will happening. But soon I get my education. I did finish one university in Russia. After I did here in Italy, Brera Academy.
Amazing,
Brera. Belle Arti in Florence. And slow, this is vision became reality, which is we did start here in Florence Academy.
That's amazing.
And we passed in classical education. Most professors there from Russia, those professors with whom we're still working for many years, almost 10 years.
Yeah, do you have a nice relationship with the professors? Do you like them or?
Definitely, I'm not taking those ones that I don't like.
I've seen a bit of hesitation.
Do you draw brushes at them when they don't do things right?
You know, Russian art is like Russian ballet. If you would like to be good, you need to take brush and say
something. I see a brush. I love that brush. Can we see the brush in the camera?
I love that.
I love it. It's amazing.
It's a very big one.
It's very long. Do brushes have different meanings? Like if you have a bigger brush... Or if you have a smaller one, does it depend on how you
use
it?
More advanced or
Is the size important, is what I mean, yeah.
Of course size important, because if you, I imagine you with a really big one, you know, you are big heart, very expressive, you need a big one. Those people who are more detailed, you know, like they are right to do things slow, they need more small one. Which is, it all depends personality, how you're using your brush. But slow, you're getting knowledge, you know, for which type of art to use what kind of brush.
Fair enough.
Of course, you're not using this as brush for watercolor, you're using this for oil painting.
Oh, okay.
All depends what kind of technique you're using.
Okay, so and how many brushes can you have if you're a painter? Can you have like 20 brushes?
More.
More?
I do have more, yeah. More. I think I'm about maybe 50.
50?
50!
Amazing!
Oh my God, that's so amazing, I would love to see that.
Can you use like forks and spoons?
Spoons, not really.
Not really.
I'm more classical. Finger, yes. Fingers, I do. But with spoons, no.
No, didn't have. Okay, sorry for even asking. Apologies to the audience as well.
That might be a modern technique, and we are classical here.
We're very classy. Yeah, we keep it classic.
From the Renaissance time.
So what do they mean? The paintings that you have in the background.
All this is work. What you see. This is one. It's in Cortina dell'Ampezzo. I think you know that place.
Cortina dell'Ampezzo. Yeah, yeah.
We do, of course.
Which is we did plein air with some of my professor, and it was really enjoyable time. Very sad because right now we're in quarantine, and then I did this picture a few years ago. It was exactly this period when in Easter break we went to have with them this is chance to paint outside. And this is one I do, it's new painting, it's not finished, which is still in progression.
I love the light that is coming from the rise, it's beautiful.
Thank you, but it's still in progression, which is, this is one what I'm working on it. This one, it was in a cage.
But what's happening?
Model posing.
What's the man doing? Is a man? Is a man on the couch?
With a child.
Yeah,
right?
That's father, and that is child. You see, they're sleeping.
Why
it's
is
like
the light?
A picture.
Why is the light only lighting the child and not the father? Is the father not important?
You had imagination about it. I'm not going to talk it.
No, we got a secret.
Everybody who see pictures, everybody who see different pictures, they have different feelings about pictures. Oh. Which is your feelings, it will keep your about pictures. My feelings, it will be my feelings about pictures. But each of us, we have this is feelings. And I believe it's so important, pictures talk by themselves, not me talking about
fair enough, fair enough. In fact, me and Erika, we always disagree on that.
I disagree with you, in fact.
Yeah, you disagree, yeah.
I feel it's like early morning.
Early morning, but it's dark. It's completely dark.
No, but it's like everything is closed and there is just like a tiny window on the top.
You know,
on the top, and there is light coming in gently. They are just asleep yet.
You know why she's saying that? Just to disagree. You know,
no.
She doesn't even think it. It's just to disagree. And what's the head? There is a head.
A man's head.
A man.
There is a sculpture behind.
Is he one of your ex? One of your ex boyfriends?
Yeah, without skin.
He did. He said the
just
wrong thing.
Flames.
Did he?
No, that is very important guy, because we're doing online classes, that guy really, that guy really helping, because he helping to understand what kind of plane and what kind of important point on the face, which is, yes, this is guy so useful.
Okay.
I suggest you to get him, yeah, if you will find in the internet, he's, you know, like really good guy.
Is it
even just decoration?
I'm a good guy, but I don't want to end up like that. So let me,
unless you want to learn portrait, is this correct? Do you use this when you are also teaching like portrait?
Okay. Exactly, this is like preparation stage, and that is called cast, and it's plain cast. And you're using that to understand the big form, big proportion, and main plane on the face.
Oh, that's amazing.
Very interesting.
I didn't know you were such an expert on
no, I'm not
decapitating men and put them on the table, yeah.
No,
so
no.
They can shut up. Oh, he's more quiet now, yeah.
I can see actually in our audience someone is saying that your face looks like you look like from a Botticelli painting.
Botticelli,
yeah.
Okay.
To Nadia, yeah, it's
not Bocelli, it's not Botticelli.
Botticelli.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, they are saying, yeah, it looks like you are coming from Botticelli painting. That's amazing.
And Nadia, we can see there is a woman as well. She's holding
a basket
with is that money?
That lady,
laundry.
That lady, she was posing in academy, which is I had chance for a few days painted with students.
Oh.
Husband for decoration put it her, said she could look nice, which was okay.
She does look nice, yeah. And she is a bit dark on her skin. Where is she from?
You know, she been a little bit dark on the skin. We have different model coming from different part of the world,
okay.
Which is those one. I even not remember from which part she was. But she had this set up as a Jewish girl.
Okay.
Which is, yes, you could see her with some decoration.
Are you calling from Florence? Are you in Florence at the moment?
Yeah, Sam and Florence, Locadia.
And how are you living this quarantine, this long quarantine?
It's really difficult because because if you have baby, that is really difficult quarantine. If you don't have baby, I could be actually enjoying just painting. But with small children, it's a little bit tough because you can't go in the park and it's not easy. We're really all hoping it will pass faster.
How many children do you have?
We heard two child.
Oh, two child. Oh, I thought you said two. That was four, yeah.
No, not 22, two.
Okay, just two.
It's
okay.
Enough two.
So two children, and is it one boy and one girl?
No, guess better.
Two girls.
No.
Oh, two boys.
Two boys.
I'm a boy.
Now I see what you said there. Okay.
They are really physical. They wanted to jump. They wanted to destroy things, which is every day what I'm doing is cleaning.
That's what I do. I throw and throw and Erica cleans.
He hides and then he throws. And actually, do they paint on the wall? Because I heard that during this quarantine in our building, our parents are looking for
things
to attach to the wall so they are free to paint all over because apparently they are going crazy.
Yeah, to keep them busy.
So are they painting your walls at home?
We did already three walls. Which is the first project, it was a ninja. Turtle ninja.
They even named that the project. Amazing.
We did it, which is the boys did their part, I did my part, we had fun. But when they start to destroy it, my part, fun finish. I told, okay, I'm doing the finition, out.
Are you planning on selling those walls to someone? Or to put them in the gallery?
Yeah, if we will, you know, if somebody will offer good money.
Yeah.
Wanted a turtle ninja after quarantine. I will sell it to Fitzy, no problem. Second project we had with them, it was all about planets because my oldest boy, he's six and he's really interesting about planet. And we did with them huge wall and that was fun too.
Amazing!
That's nice. Yeah. I would love to see this.
And applause to that. Applause to that.
To children painting because I think that's very, very important. Yeah.
I mean, you're applauding now.
Really, is a creativity.
Now you suggested an applause to children painting, and then when I paint the wall, you always.
No, I'm always happy when you paint. That's the only time actually.
It's just such a lie.
I don't say anything about it.
Do not believe her. So let's get to know you better.
Yes.
Are you single at the moment or are you on the market?
I'm with two boys and husband.
And a husband, okay.
How you think? You know, for now I just have him, which is,
She is happily married.
Yeah, happily married, okay.
I am family, yeah.
Okay, you know, just to know, you know, because maybe someone from the audience wanted to make a move and just to know that there are no slots available whatsoever.
She's taken, you can only learn painting.
Yeah, busy.
Okay, fair enough.
And art. Why did you start art? Why did you start this career in the art industry?
Not for the birds, not for the 2,000 birds, yeah.
That is a story coming to children age. I think we all as a child have dream. And I remember I always wanted to paint, which is I had that dream. And no one actually wanted to help me because in Russia we have professional education for children. But when I wanted to do it, I was still too young. Normally you're getting in this special school for children, like professional school, art school, by your 8 or 7. And I was in my 6. And we did pass around this school and I was with grandma and I pull her and tell her, listen, you need to bring me. I want to go there. And she said, no one will take you. You are 6, you are too young for that school. But grandma, she's nice, you know, you will have nice grandmas, which is the grandma anyway brought me. And it was one more lady, so nice, and she said, how old are you? I'm like 6. She's like, do you want paint? I'm like, yes, I do. And she said, okay, let's
well,
paint.
You can't.
And she put me in class. And she put me in class, and from 6, I was most youngest in this school for painting children, painting
amazing,
school for children.
Yeah, amazing.
That's amazing.
She took me.
Close to when you want something, you go and you get it.
Yes.
Anyway, it's great.
That is what I had in my really young age, which is I really know it's something what I want to do, and I know if I wanted to get it, I need to do something.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So from 6 years ago. You travel a lot? Do you travel a lot for selling your paintings or for meeting with your artists?
I did. Before I had a baby, I did travel so much. Okay. Which is, I think each month I was traveling somewhere. But when you're getting the baby and they had one after another, unfortunately my travels was somehow stopped. But maybe a year ago when I did start again travel, which is we already visited with babies America. We've been all together for exhibition, for school exhibition, which is, yeah, we started.
Have you ever fallen in love with some of your artists before meeting your husband or after?
With artists, no.
No, the artist would artist, not be no. your type.
I think it's enough me as an artist. It's not easy people, it's very moody people.
Okay.
In same time, very intelligent people. Yeah. It's not easy to be around with that people.
I know.
And I think I'm not like that, I'm like that too, which is it's already, you know, like it's not easy to be near me. Mm.
I know, and probably the guy with his head on the table, he knows this as well, yeah. It wasn't easy.
His face definitely say yes.
He has learned it the hard way, yeah.
He learned how to be silent, you see, this is the important part.
Exactly. Shut up!
Our audience is asking a question which a lot
of questions.
Your number one tip on painting while traveling?
Yeah.
Of course, probably it's plein air and sketch.
Oh, sketch, okay.
Sketch and plein air.
It's not, yeah, sketches, definitely. But if you're traveling for beautiful places and you're a painter, you're not just like to draw, but you would like to work with paints, you need to have setup for painting. And that type of painting normally called plein air. When you go outside and painting.
And then number one tip in general about painting. When you start for the first time, you get your brush and that's your first class.
And can you use a brush as a weapon?
Or probably you don't even have a brush when you just get started, right?
Yeah, you're not started probably when you're a child with brush. It's, as I already mentioned, I had love to the art when I was a child. And you started with things what mom give you. I
with
suppose
your hands,
it was something like... Exactly, or hands or pencil. I still working with my finger. Especially when you're trying to gloss, something finger is best material.
Yeah. A cheaper as well, you have them already. So no need to buy new
exactly.
ones. Yeah.
You don't need to buy that with you always.
I mean, you have already 10. Or plus you have another 10
exactly.
on the feet, so it's already
a
set.
You can do amazing art.
A human being set
great,
of 20.
Great observation.
Lots of free
exactly,
tools,
yeah. You just like throw yourself onto the canvas.
Yes,
right? And
yeah.
You start making art.
Can you sing?
Better don't hear it.
No, better not hear it.
Do you sing while you paint?
I like to listen music, but when you're painting, it's a very intellectual process, which is your brain working a lot.
Yeah.
And if you know how to do analytical type of painting, you don't have so much space for singing, at least me. Because I try to question myself if I'm doing what I want to do, if it's enough good, yeah. If it's enough light, shadow.
I never have that sensation, that feeling, my brain working. Just, I'm more like running, you know, running in the house. Why do you laugh? You should have said no, Marco, you're very intelligent.
No. You are very intelligent, I don't have to say that, you are.
You're sure?
Are, you know that you are. How you are spending this quarantine? Are you like just relaxing and painting sometimes? Or like, what are you doing?
Actually, when you're going sleep, I still wake up with baby at least 4-3 times at night. And in the morning, I don't have that fresh face because I still a mom and I wake up at night, you know. Somebody
enough,
wanted
yeah.
to drink, somebody...
Nobody
yeah.
would.
Yeah, morning started from baby. Baby already wake up and you still not because you did woke up at night time.
Is your husband helping you?
Try to do...
In all of these?
Yes, we're working.
Oh, yeah, he does,
we do working together. He do.
He doesn't want to hand up on one of your tables.
After you have almost question, when you have baby at home per second month, it's like no children garden, no school, and you start to have morning question. Mom, what is this? Mom, let's do that. And it's actually not so much time to paint, but I'm trying to dedicate my time and
can you say no?
It's not easy with my baby to say no, but I suppose it's not easy for no one baby to say no. You mom, you can't say no. It's like it's mom, you know, it's yours. Mom,
of course,
you should say yes and play.
When I want something, I always call my mother. Yeah, I always go, Mom, I need this. She goes, yeah, it's done.
Yeah. Still, that's how you do, right?
When I want to have a fight, I call my father.
I really hope I don't will have it. Anyway, yeah, for a moment, I'm still going with more like mom direction. Because they can't go outside, they can't play outside, and it's boring for them.
Of course,
and they're just destroying home. That's what we're doing. We're destroying home after we're putting again, cleaning everything, after we're again destroying.
Okay, someone is asking, natural charcoal or compressed?
Or compressed the charcoal.
Natural.
Natural.
Compressed one, I mean, I'm not so much working with charcoal. Just when I was a student, and when you started to work with some work, you started with charcoal. But in the end, when you're already knowing how to draw, how to paint, you start straight away with paint.
You sell paintings as well, right? All around the world.
Yeah.
Which is the kind of paintings that they sell the most?
Probably most one will be something landscape. Quite a lot of requests right now, especially about portraiture.
Okay, so...
You're doing commission of the portraits and...
like eccentric people.
It's good to have. You can have yourself in your wall.
We have one.
That's a great idea.
We do have.
We can even show it.
You see? And I'm trying to do right now focus for my personal work, like more composition, something what I would like to do for myself. But very often I'm not sell it. Because it's something what I would like to keep.
Are you saying these so that the price will go higher? Like, I know I'm gonna sell it. So the people will offer you more money. Yeah?
You know, telling honestly, I'm not so much focused on selling product. It's not something what I really focus. Because my time, it's dedicated for academy. Okay. Or for my family, or for my creative projects.
Oh, I know your point.
It's not my mindset.
This is brilliant.
I love that.
Yeah.
Have you ever told to a student, you are the worst?
You know, I believe if it's person really have a desire to do things, people could actually achieve their dream.
Okay.
And it's something what I see per years. Academy existing 10 years. If you're asking me, I could telling you people who may be thinking about themselves less arrogant, getting better in education, respect those one who became with arrogant feelings.
Amazing. I mean, an applause to pursue your dreams.
Absolutely.
Yes. Even though you are very talented, you need to pursue your dreams and get there and do your homework. This is an art academy, art academy in the heart of Florence.
Yes, it is.
Yes, we didn't say this at the beginning.
We're in Florence. We're in Florence in the. We are International Art Academy in Florence, but we are recognized by Tuscany region, which is we're giving recognized diploma.
If they join the school, do they have any chance to win a ticket to Russia as well?
To visit Russia.
To win. That is a very, very, very important part, to win a ticket.
Exactly.
Definitely. Yeah, you could win now, you could win wherever.
What does a typical week of classes look like at the Florence Classical Arts Academy?
So they are working with a life model, which is typical class. It will be analytical, constructive drawing, and working with life model things, trying to pass a Russian approach.
Are they naked?
To pass definitely, if you're in third year. Third year, doing always naked people.
Can I join your class?
But we have stage. We built our own didactic. It's why we did recognize from Tuscany, because we built those didactic which is helping you to grow from zero knowledge up to really high level, finishing with your own art project. Yes. So you could arrive at any level with any knowledge, and you're going with a stage from zero up to life model. nude model.
Okay.
And composition project, your own like diploma project, your own idea.
You can become a Michelangelo in the end, right? Or try at least.
We believe in it. We believe that our students will become maybe even better.
If you become a Michelangelo, do you need to change your name in Michelangelo? No?
No, you
can you keep yours? Okay.
You should keep yours.
I'm just asking.
You know, very important part is to became. Which is first became. And after decide. Yeah. You would like to change. You don't.
That's
important
fine.
To became.
But if you don't change, get out of the class.
In Russia, you will be having that attitude. When I was taught, it was like, if you're not good, out. Because in Russia we get, you know, like free education. I was still in like post-communism period. And we had different type of professor. But I'm trying to get people here in Italy, in Florence, those one who will passing not just their passion, but love to student. And really with compassion growing them from stage when they are to those which is they need to become. And this is probably difference between us and any education what you could
yes,
find in Russia.
Yes, yeah. I mean, that's amazing. An applause for that. Great. So
what type
do you teach abstract?
Yeah, which is we are academic basic school and we are doing academic approach. Yeah. This is traditional analytical approach, how to learn to paint, how to become good. But we believe after you know everything, how to do well, you need to learn for your own style. And if you abstract artist, great, do it. But you will know how to do it with good composition, good proportion, good color feelings, understanding about technique, different technique, how to use this technique in your particular art world. Important knowledge. If you have knowledge, you could create wherever you want. And first you need to receive knowledge and after to find yourself.
Absolutely, an applause to knowledge is power.
Knowledge, starting from the basics, which are the fundamentals, right? It's like ballet when you are looking at towards modern jazz and contemporary. Yeah. If you start from ballet, that's...
In my life, I did for many years artistic gymnastic and after I did jazz.
So are you a prima ballerina?
No, I'm not.
You second? Second ballerina?
Oh. You know, I'm mom horse now.
Your mamba
ballerina. I know what it's mean to receive knowledge.
Yeah.
If you have good academic approach in ballet, it's giving you possibility or giving you freedom to express yourself as you wish. And painting is same. If you have really good, really profound knowledge how to do things, you could express yourself how you wish.
Yeah, yeah. And applause to it. I mean, this is such a wisdom.
It's very wise.
Are you planning like an expansion? What are you planning? To focus more on something or to expand your academy? A new husband? More children?
We do have vision of what we would like to do. And we would like to open more different direction in academy. Because right now, per 10 years, we were so much focused to build a really good didactic.
Okay.
To give possibility for students from like no knowledge or really limited knowledge achieve high level in education. And now we wanted to do different direction, which is we are really focusing to do something with design, maybe even with a tattoo artist. And we're just trying to dream about what we would like and try to go with that.
Okay, that answers everything.
Well, there are tons of questions.
There are tons of questions, actually. would I be able to get a good amount of knowledge if I take 1 year?
What is going on with didactic program?
Yeah.
Didactic program build what you started with a simple form goes towards portraiture.
Okay.
Which is 1 year process of education. For first year, it's exactly focusing from understanding whole form, those guys, understanding about three-dimensional proportions and slow go to life model. And life model, you're finishing first year education with understanding with life model from zero up to portrait.
Zero up to,
Answer yes, portrait yes. Second year you started with knowledge of the portrait and goes towards half body, doing your composition, doing your sketches, doing color study, doing art history, anatomy, like
you look
all
very
those,
dangerous with
because
that brush.
You don't have just painting and drawing. You have a lot of different components in your education process. In third year, it goes full body and with your diploma project about composition.
Amazing. So it's basically it's a 2 years program.
Or three.
Or three. Yeah. I got lost because she was talking with this brush. It was like, and then you go there and then, you know.
I would love to see her painting live. That would be amazing.
Actually, we might plan one live session with you painting. If you want to. We're going to send you one of our paintings. No paintings, one of our pictures. You can do a portrait. We are the inspiration for the world, for the whole world.
Thank you so much for joining.
Thank you so much. You have been fantastic, absolutely.
Thank you so much. It was really great talk with you, and you have really wonderful humor. But
thank you so much. No.
Yeah, it was a pleasure.
We do.
Light conversation, like you promise.
We deliver what we promise. Yeah. And bye for now, and say hello to your family as well, to the poor Henry.
To the poor Henry there, and all the protagonists.
You named him, that's great.
Thank you so much, dear.
Have a wonderful afternoon.
Love you. See you later.
Bye.
See you. Bye.
It was brilliant, and great to know about it's great. In fact, you need to know the tools of your work, if you think about it. It's important to nurture your talent.
Exactly.
Because if you don't have the tools, you don't know how to create, and then you do everything like with losing energy.
Exactly, but also going back to the basics. So yes. Going back to the classical fundamentals, and then you can go abstract, you can do whatever you
yes,
want.
Yeah.
But starting from the very classical basics, that's a very good advice.
Thank you so much. Yeah,
it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you. That was brilliant. Guys, thank you so much for watching. We hope that you enjoyed the show and our singing at the beginning. I think that was glorious.
Absolutely. Yours especially.
And mine especially, yeah. I mean,
mine is always a disaster.
Ed Sheeran should be delighted that I was singing his songs. We are probably going to drop him a couple of messages and see what he says.
Hopefully, he'll join us and teach us his song properly.
Yes, he will join us in the next few weeks, so stay tuned for that. And we're going to see you next time, which is going to be on Monday.
Monday, always on Between Two Italians with Marco and Erica and amazing guests between us.
Bye, guys. Ciao.
Bye.